beginning with thanking our senior scholar, Dr. Srinivas Rithi, who has traveled so many miles to be with us today, and so that in person we could receive the award. And we are grateful that you shared so much of your past academic experience with us. I thank your son for presenting that information to us and to members of your family for accompanying you here today. Dr. Devangana Desai, I must thank you for filling in for Dr. Sharma. Do please inform him that we missed his presence here, but we're grateful to you also for conveying his message to us. Of course, you are one of us, and so we're very happy to have you with us again today, because you've been our past vice president for so many years. Dr. Anish Pradhan, I applaud your musical talent, and we are really proud of having you as a member and for contributing so much to Hindustani music and to tabla in particular. Justice Sujata Manohar, I thank you for your positive response. She didn't hesitate. All she said was, when I phoned her and asked if she'd preside, she said, give me a minute to look at my calendar. That's all it took, and I really appreciate that readiness with which you agreed to be here today to preside at this very important function, but also for the continued interest you're taking in the society, for your valuable comments you have made today. It made me think that you'd be a very good researcher, and would you like to take on some research work for us? Because look at all that she did. She read, she told us the information she gave us, and I'd like to tell you that we are in the process of preparing a vision statement, and we'd be very happy to have you look at it also and contribute. Professor Naik, my relationship with you goes back many, many, many years at the university level. But again, today I learned something when you told us about humanized, equalized, spiritualized. So you're always teaching us something new, Professor Nayak, and we remain your students, ready to learn from you. Today, I think, is the culmination of years of scholarship and the contribution that you have made to the study of history. Hundreds and hundreds of students have benefited, and I'm sure they will be very happy to once again see your book. I think we've all heard this statement that behind every successful man is a woman. I am not surprised at that at all, but I appreciate the fact that you thanked your wife for all that she has done so that you could continue. When she's been so busy teaching mathematics, you should have been giving her some help in the house. So thank you, Mrs. Nayak, for being here, for members of your family also. There are so many relatives and friends of the people who for whom today's function was planned, and I thank all of them for coming here to encourage your relatives, your friends. We appreciate your presence here. Manisha Tikekar, I'm truly grateful to you for being here with us today, and I look forward to you participating with your scholarship, the work you've been doing, to participate in many, many arguments. Manisha, I hope to see you very often at the Asiatic Society. To the monograph writers, Dr. Sonali Ednekar and Dr. Namrata Kaneri, my thanks for finally completing. I'm joking, everyone has so much work, and then, you know, we were all harassing them and come on, hurry up. And of course, to Usha Thakkar and her team for taking on this responsibility, for ensuring that the work continues. We're truly grateful to all of you, to all my colleagues, vice presidents here today, the work they've put in, particularly Dr. Meena Vaishampayan, who's always a guiding force and ensuring that I don't forget things and reminding me, have you done this and this has to be done. My special thanks to you. Since I'm talking about the monographs, I must thank Indus Source and Sonavi Desai for printing the monographs and for giving them to us on time. Murli, Mr. Murli Ranganathan, hours of labor. He's himself confessed how he harassed Professor Nayak and Mrs. Nayak, so I won't say anything more about that. But that is because I think he strives for perfection. So he won't take anything less than that. And I'm so glad that he identified Jack Printers. Thank you so much. I know that they've done a very, very good job. If you just go by the cover, just look at the cover, then you feel tempted to open the pages and start reading. You must have heard the phrase, don't judge a book by its cover. I'm asking you to judge it because the cover is so good, the contents are bound to be equally good. Again, I remind you that the books are out, monographs and Professor Nayak's book out on sale. Mr. Rikame, who handles this game, and whispered in my ear, please tell them we won't take old notes. So I said, don't worry, nobody will be doing that. We're all aware of the situation. That's why I said, if you have your checkbook, checks will be accepted. Meena Vaishapent already thanked Mr. Natwarlal Shah, for his generous contribution setting up the Vimal Shah Fund, which is making these publications possible. And I think we can continue to produce such scholarly publications thanks to the generosity of Mr. Natwarlal Shah and the Shah family. Professor Rupa Shah has sent her apologies. Seems her daughter, the plane was delayed, landed late, and so she got held up at the airport. Otherwise, she would have represented the Shah family. Mr. Kale has already referred to the donors, without whom all these things, the lovely Darbar Hall, the AC, the sound system, and everything that we've been able to do. So I would just say a quick thank you to all the donors for the interest they have shown, for helping to keep this 213-year institution going. And I'm sure you will agree, it's still going strong, it's still being sustained, thanks to our members and to the generosity of the donors. In particular, I would like to mention the government of Maharashtra, because I think we have a stereotype of the government as being supportive of activities that yield immediate results or visible results. And I think that stereotype was broken when they recognized the Asiatic Society and what it's doing and gave this generous amount of 5 crores. It sounds very generous, but you've no idea how quickly it is exhausted. So we're hoping that someone from government is listening to me and making provisions for another 5-10 crores maybe. But I think we need to recognize the fact that we've valued something that is related to academic research, to the preservation of books in this digitization that we've undertaken, because the returns here are not so tangible, but eventually they do yield stronger results. I hope you'll all agree that it's been a very successful evening, and for that, once again, let me thank, first of all, our president, Mr. Kale, without whose advice and support we would not be able to function, to all the office bearers, the managing committee, and I would like to mention Mr. Mane, our administrative officer, and his entire staff. They work as a team, they work with enthusiasm, they work with pride in the institution. And I think that's what makes our job, because we work, ours posts are honorary, we run around doing other things, and we come in and do what we can, but they are the ones, they are the backbone. And so I need to recognize that. And of course, I must thank you, members. Press for responding to our invitation and for sharing in our celebrations today. Good night. I am sorry. This came in just yesterday, our Asiatic Journal. Unfortunately, we haven't got enough copies, otherwise we would have launched it today, but it's ready.